This week on HomeKit News, the ZemiSmart curtain driver with HomeKit. So today we're looking at a product that I'm not really in need of, as I don't have curtains. And even though the box says blinds and curtains, this really is only for curtains, unless you have vertical blinds that use tracks or a rod perhaps. Just like previous ZemiSmart products I've looked at, this uses Zigbee and therefore requires the ZemiSmart hub for smart control as well as HomeKit functionality. Let's dive right in and see what's in the box. So whilst I'm looking at the contents of the box, to the side there's some pertinent info should you need it. But first of all, we've got the manual, which is in English, so that's a good start. There's also an included solar panel, although there seems to be no way of fitting it to the motor, which is a bit strange. There are two sets of cables for powering the device or recharging the internal battery. And as you can see, we're still in micro USB territory, which isn't terribly surprising for a budget device, I guess. Next up is the motor itself, which certainly feels quite solid and hefty. We'll look at the motor in more detail a bit later. Another extra, besides the solar panel, is an included RF remote control, which is definitely a bonus even if it's not exposed to HomeKit as such. It's also nice that it comes with two AAA batteries. The final parts are for connecting the motor to your curtains and your curtain rail or rod. So this first pair are for curtain rods only, and should fit rods up to 28mm in diameter. You also get two pairs of arms, for want of a better description, that are designed for U-rail curtain tracks, and it's great that they've included two separate sizes as you can see here, although I don't know the size specs on these. The final pair of parts are for I-rail curtain tracks, so with all these options I think most people are going to be covered. Let's have a closer look at the motor, and as already stated, it doesn't feel like it would easily fall apart. The top has a rubber wheel that sits up against the curtain rod or rail to move itself and your curtains. This top portion is removable if required. You do get on-device buttons to control the motor directly, although as it's possibly going to be high up and behind a curtain, I'm guessing this is only of use in emergencies ultimately. I guess if there's an issue with controlling it in HomeKit, then the remote control is also going to be useful in these cases. So as you can see here, the wheel is moving when I press the open button, when I press the close or stop buttons, just so you can see the motor in action. It is quite quiet, although once it's pulling curtains, the motor may well be a little noisier. In my case, I'm using a curtain rod, so I just need to fit the pair of connecting arms, which simply click into the adjustable side holders. If you need to remove these arms to start over, a small screwdriver will do the trick by just lifting the teeth that grip the arms. With the motor fitted, you can see that the wheel isn't quite gripping the rod, so you just need to make the fit a little bit tighter. These side holders are spring-loaded, so even if the grip is a little tight, they'll adjust accordingly. This is gripping nicely now, so you can see in principle how the motor works with the curtain rod. I just need to add the curtains next so you get the full picture, but this gives you a good idea of how it works in principle. As I don't have curtains in the house, I've had to set up a couple of temporary placements so you can see it in action. I've already added the motor to the hub and set up the limits, so it's already working in HomeKit as you can see here. Now I purchased both a set of curtains and a curtain rod specifically for these demos from IKEA, but I would say the size and weight of these curtains are within the boundaries of what the motor is designed to work with. ZemiSmart's website states that the motor is capable of pulling up to 10 kilos or 22 pounds. One tip I do have is that it helps to tie the end of the curtain to the outer ring on the motor. This way the edge of the curtain is kept in position when the curtains are opening. So here's a quick look at the motor in the Home app and the Toyo Smart Life app, although in HomeKit there's really nothing to see other than the slider for adjusting the opening position, which you also get in the Toyo app. The Toyo app also shows you battery levels, which isn't exposed to HomeKit, and you do need the Toyo app for initial setup, which is basically for setting the open and close limits. But other than that, the Home app is just fine. Onto the remote, and in addition to basic open, pause and close buttons, the remote has buttons to set the blinds to three specific points, 20%, 50% and 80%, which makes the remote a bit more handy than you might think. Because the remote connects directly to the motor using the 433 MHz radio frequency, The reaction times are pretty instantaneous. So if you want to appease a member of the family who's not totally sold on the smart home experience, give them this. There's a rather large red LED emitted from the remote, but in my opinion, that only serves to let you know, in no uncertain terms, that this device is definitely sending a signal. Next up, a quick noise test, so I'll stay quiet. At around 35 dB, I'd say that's not too bad. Finally, onto the pros and cons, and even though this isn't in use in my home, I did have it working for a full 7 days, testing for disconnections, the motor getting stuck, or with failed automations, and it performed without any issues in these respects in that time. So for the pros, I think if you're on a budget, this could be a quick and easy way of getting your curtains smart, although there's a caveat, which is in the con side of things. The motor was a lot quieter than I expected, although the whirring sound of the motor could be annoying for some, I suppose. Installation was really very easy, and even easier than with the equivalent roller shade motor, even if I found the instructions a little confusing at first. With extras like the solar panel and the remote, it's hard to complain that you're getting an almost complete solution for a decent price. Still, for me, whilst I've used retrofit devices like locks and roller shade drivers in the past, in the case of the curtain motor, I do find this particular solution a little bit on the clunky side, although that's a personal thing. And the final con is that if you have a pair of curtains, you're going to need a pair of motors. So combined with the cost of the hub, things can get more expensive than anticipated. That's our overview of the ZemiSmart curtain motor, but if you have any questions or comments, feel free to ask. If you found this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe if you haven't already. And until the next time, stay safe and learn the cha-cha.